Rock and mountain climbing can be a tough but exhilarating sport. Now, this is the Rhode Island Rock Gym inside in the year 2000. So picture outside in Peru 100 years ago, and you begin to get a picture of Annie Smith Peck, the world's most famous mountain climber.
She was the first woman ever to apply to Brown University and was turned down. Annie Smith Peck was born at 865 North Main Street in Providence in 1850 and died in New York City in 1935. During 84 and a half years of life, she got in a lot of education despite Brown and a lot of living.
One of her brothers and her mother accused her of insanity for wanting to go to Brown University. She was not admitted. It was recommended that she go to Vassar, but she didn't care to go to school with a bunch of girls, so she went off to Michigan.
She graduated from the University of Michigan with high honors, and after teaching for a while, got the urge to climb. And climb she did, all the way to the top of the Matterhorn in 1895, and became a world celebrity. Annie had trouble raising money for some of these climbs because she had to hire guides, but she did raise it and achieved her greatest triumph by reaching the highest point ever recorded by man or woman, the north peak of Mount Roscarán in Peru. It was 1908. Annie was 58 years old. The news went round the world, and even late in life, Annie used to say, "I've climbed higher than Lindbergh ever flew." Her exploits still inspire.
She was very instrumental in women's climbing, and that is mountaineering, and not technical rock climbing, but mountaineering with climbing with an ice axe and other equipment. And she started the movement. Really, she was a women's suffragette, and started climbing at the age of 38, which was fairly old at that time, and didn't climb her first major peak until she was that age. I believe it was Mount Shasta in California.
Annie never married, but there is a hint of romance, again connected to Brown. School President Benjamin Andrews may have had a crush on Annie. In 1929, she wrote to then-President William H.P. Fonts, "Dr. Andrews told me of his early love 30 years too late. He told me, your letters are the acme of love literature, which I wish I could preserve."
She mentions friendship with him and compares him to Robert Browning and... Well, he didn't speak up or anything, only many years later.
At the end of her life, Annie had one more goal, to fly over the South American mountains she had climbed. She took that flight at the age of 82, and later that year, climbed Mount Madison in New Hampshire. Annie Smith Peck died on July 18, 1935. She was buried across the street from her place of birth at the North Burial Ground in Providence. No less than Amelia Earhart once said of Annie, "I feel like such an upstart beside her." Well, Brown may have said no then, but it probably wouldn't say no today to the woman not to be forgotten. Glenn Laxton, 12 News.